George Hammerbacher back in the booth. We've got age versus beauty here. Mr. Claudio Parrone, he's a pool room operator from Kenosha, Wisconsin, maybe 30, 35 miles down the road south of Milwaukee. I encountered Claudio for the first time way back, maybe in the 1970s when I was around here, and again in the 1990s when they had a regional tour on big tables here in Wisconsin. And he's a very good player. Mr. Sergio Rivas looks very stylish. I was watching him practice. This is race to six, eight ball. And we're underway. If that eight ball would have fallen, it would not have counted playing the BCA league rules. The eight ball would have spotted. And Sergio would have had his option as to what he chose to do. He could play at any shot he wanted to, highs or lows. He had an open table, just like he does now. Okay, he selected high balls, and these balls look like they're pretty good. He's going to have to get on the 11 now, I believe. He did, but he might be a little straighter in on this ball than he might have liked. And here, I say to my immediate right is my man originally from Newport News, Virginia. Now he's in Las Vegas, CSI man, Mr. Ozzie Reynolds.
How you doing, George?
Oh, man, I am just eating this up. Having a great time.
Literally, I hope.
Oh, that too. I stopped over on the food court before, and let's just say abuse was the name of the game.
Well, folks, this is Ozzie Reynolds, CueSports International. George, I want to thank you for agreeing to come out and commentate this awesome tournament over this long weekend.
This is a lot of fun. It's a little nippy outside.
Yeah, not quite the Las Vegas weather that I left.
He said try to draw this ball off the three or off the five. Look at this roll.
Nice.
He's just skip to the loo. He's just gonna just pinch it. He better pinch it because this. He might have some troubles here. Yeah. He just had to lob it in. These are double-A men's singles. This Claudio Parrone is an excellent player, too. Sergio broke, and it's getting ready to send it in. Sergio takes a 1-0 lead over Claudio.
And actually, George, this is the AA/Master singles division.
Okay.
Masters go to six, AA players go to five. Both of these guys are master players. So this is just simply a race to six. And I'm not going to stay in here very long because I think I've got the second worst voice in all of mankind. But I did want to thank everybody for watching. Hope you enjoy it all weekend. I'll come in and out and say hi. But thanks for watching and thanks to all the players that showed up. We're going to have a great tournament. We had well over 500 entries so far. We're still taking on-site signups for the other divisions. So if you're nearby Milwaukee and you want to play, come on down and see us. You can sign up on-site.
All right.
George, hold the fort down, buddy.
One more time. All right, here we go. Claudio, let's see if he can answer here. Uh, Claudio is a very, very strong fundamental player. And he's, you can see he's from the old style. See how tall he stands up. But he didn't. He got chilly rolled on the break. And but this is a nasty looking six ball looking mess on the one there with the eight in the middle of it all. And it might take a miner's license with a pickaxe to run this wreck. Very tough. Low balls look like the only shot in town. He's gonna try to spin into the two, I think. No, he was, but his angle was just a little bit too severe. Oddly enough, the two ball, all the low balls are all clear. He has the eight ball is the only ball that's really tough, and that's plenty tough, but the two can break it out. Right here, he's gonna nip this ball. He's gonna catch a piece of the 13 and draw his ball right at the six ball or the five. He's got his choice. He's gonna try to hit the 13 just like that, but he didn't do himself any favors. He's killing his soldiers here, folks. The old man taught me about this game a little bit. Over 50 years ago, told me, don't kill your soldiers unless you know you're a lock to win the war. That was his advice to me playing eight ball. Because Claudio can play games around him with the moves if he gets a shot. So, making these balls, I don't know what his market is. He's going to try to, even though if he breaks it out now, he doesn't have any market. The one ball's tough on the cushion. There's no real reward that I could see based on a combination of my experience and my opinion. He might be trying to fall on the one and draw into it off the one. No. Might be trying to hit him here. But this is the magical mystery tour if he can land on the one after breaking the eight out of this mess. It's low percentage. Oh, he did. What a shot. That was just beautiful. Now he's just got to stay down and do what he's got to do. Uh-oh. All the way to the rail. Beautiful run out from Sergio Rivas. I don't know too much about Sergio. He's a young man. Probably the last time I was in Wisconsin living in the late 80s, I don't think this young man was kicking or screaming or anything. But he's ahead 2-0. This is alternate break. Call your ball, call your pocket. Make a ball on the break. You have the player breaking has his or her option as to what group to select, but they have to make a called shot in order to claim a group of balls. Combinations are allowed. on any combination other than the 8 first. Make the 8 on the break, you don't win. Safeties, hit your ball and then hit a rail after contact with cue ball or any other object ball. Oh, a crusher break. But he made lots of high balls. Made two high balls, but the low balls look like a little bit better. I like him a lot here on the low balls. That looks ideal to me. He's gonna try to break it out right here with this one ball. He's gonna play left-hand bottom ball. He's gonna maybe try to fade in off the deuce. That's a good play too. He'll play the 2, then the 1, and break him up. Or play the 5. He can do that too. 5 hit the 15, and these balls are all tap ins. Perfect. Just routine. Looks like, barring an earthquake, Sergio Rivas will be halfway home in this match. Sergio Rivas 3. Claudio Parrone, nothing. Claudio broke the balls one time and came up dry. And Sergio has run all 3 wrecks, 2 off of his break and 1 off of Claudio's break. Sergio has played perfect so far. Perfect he's played. Yeah, I don't think he was born the last time I was playing around this state in around 90, 91. I don't know. I don't think the light struck him in the face yet. He might be questionable whether he could get served, that boy. He's a good player, though. Claudio hits him hard, makes a ball, and his 9-5 are tied up. He's going to have to fall on the short side of the 9 or 5 if he's so inclined. He doesn't really have a good ball to fall on the 9. And that's what he's looking at. I know he doesn't like this. It's all but the 9 ball. He's got to start shooting some balls and just get a stroke going a little bit. Maybe make a move. was looking to come a little farther than that on the 15 ball. Uh-oh, he got on the short side of nine. Nice shot. That was the key shot in the rack. Draws ball off of this ball to the 10. This is touchy position as these balls are. He's going to slice the 12. Missed it. Oh boy. Technically, that's the first ball that got missed in this match. Might be trying to play the 5 off the 12 to open up his pocket for the 3 ball. Play high left, high right ball or come 2 cushions. He's going 2 cushions, playing low left. He's going to maybe go off the 12. Oh, yeah, he was trying to. Didn't get there, though. It's going to be a hard run. We got a nice little crowd just forming around this table. These are some fans and players that appreciate a couple of very, very fine regional players here. Claudio has been a top regional player for over 35 years. When you see, look at this on the short side. That's brilliant. He might be able to put the garlic breath on this ball on the 3. Play it in off the 11. But it might be a little tight. Won the carom, you know, but it's that's the only shot he has, really. Doesn't have a full range of hits because he's on the rail. I wonder if he's going to try to cut the 3 to his right. Yeah, he is. He's going to turn his rock loose unless he's shooting at the 6. He fired at it. But he left Claudio Parrone a very, very nice... Well, not the greatest. The 8 ball's not any great shakes where it is, but he still has a couple pockets for it. He's got to shoot the 12 and draw it back to the 10. Oh. We played a side and rolled to the 8 all the way across table, I think. I should have thought it made more of a commitment across table. Overcut it. But that's the bad news. The good news is that he totally protected his cue ball. you know, that there might be a kiss shot. Three ball off the inside of the seven. If the four doesn't go. It did. I guess that's 16 years old. That's what my intel just is running past me, and I said this kid already has treachery in his heart at age 16. Playing a guy that's maybe four times older. Kid's very stylish. Might like to kiss shot in the side off that seven ball. Trouble is that the three goes at the eight. Like the kiss shot. Might as well shoot it. Or play safe all the way to the rail. Yeah, I was going to say, that's the shot. Trouble is that the three might pocket the eight. Oh, he did Claudio dirty. Tough match. I like, Claudio might have a good safety here because he can come off the edge of the eight, put his cue ball between the first and second diamonds, top rail, and maybe hide all the above. Yeah, they have a little camaraderie. I think they might be on the same team. And this kid might even be Claudio's protege. I don't know. I've been away from this region for a good many years. He's one of the few players left that I'm. Looking at the bank, but the bank is a suicide shot. Safe is probably, well, he's going to call the bank. He's banking for the cash. There's a guy named Buddy Hall said he'd rather always lose on a tough shot than a tough safe. And since he's in the Hall of Fame, I would have to take that with strong respect. Good shot. Yeah, he's 60 plus years old, I'm sure, and he can. I still don't see any glasses on that guy. That's the only thing left on me that hadn't gone is my eyes. Had two artificial hips. I got artificial heart valve, a pacemaker. But Claudio gets on the board with a brilliant shot. He had to shoot. This kid better break the balls good again. He hits the ball strong. Looks like it's the two ball or nothing. If he can see it. Yeah. He actually looked like that rail first might have been a better shot than he had got to 14 out of there, or 15. I like him shooting the safe here. Let's see what he comes with here. A defensive shot. But these balls are kind of open, really. Except for the 15's out down near the one. He's got too sharp an angle, I think, to hold for the 11. Nah, he didn't want to shoot that ball. His body language told me that. Didn't want to shoot it. He I don't blame him. I wouldn't want to shoot it either. If he didn't want to shoot it. Can't leave a kid like this sort of opportunity. He even fell on the sunny side of that one ball to go up table. He's sunny side up from here. It looks like 1, 5, 7, and 8 to me. Oh, he made a mistake. He got a little irresponsible with his nugget. Got caught in a bad neighborhood. In fact, he might have gotten mugged over there. Calling the bank, and the bank looks like he's going to look to see if the ball's frozen. That was so he, as long as he makes a continual stroke, not a push. That's Claudio's laughing because I'm not so sure about that one myself, but I'm not in this game. I'm an observer. Claudio's laughing, but I think that that was the opposite of pull that we saw there, folks, and whatever that word is, it's a four-letter word. But I'm not in the game, so what I say is only going out on the cyberspace, maybe outer space, who knows. See what Claudio can come up with here. No. Well, this almost looks like a natural to go off the 10 and into those two balls. His angle's wide. He plays the side. I'm not sure what he's doing. Claudio might be getting this kid out of stroke, which is what he can do. He's kind of like a Svengali type. There's good news, and there's bad news. You got to twist your rock, kid, with the right, spin, and just fall on your bottom rail all the way over on your right side. He's shooting at this ball. That went one match with the tall kid, that Robbie. He passed on a shot like this, played safe, and it did him good. Well, you can't fault being a straight shooter, though. No, you cannot. 4-1. Sergio Rivas takes a 4-1 lead over Mr. Claudio Parrone, billiard room operator. We're here at the beautiful Pottawatomie Casino and Hotel in downtown Milwaukee, Wisconsin. This is the official host and sponsor of the 2015 BCA leagues. This is the state championships of Wisconsin. All you operators, get on board with the BCA. They have a spectacular tournament out at the Rio in July. 6,000-7,000 people. Really get next to some excitement. Claudio, just kind of. He doesn't have much of an angle on this ball either. Jacked up a little bit. But he's got a good combination down there, 12-9, it seems. But he's actually got a... He's being a little on the wrong side of it. He was looking to see if the 13 passed the 5. See what he does. He could only cinch that ball and straight in. Might be playing the 13 now, which is, if it doesn't make dollars, it doesn't make sense. Oh. He floats her in. He's a little wrong on this. He's going to play the 9 and have to get a little fortunate. Even though I like the 14 better. That's all he can do is push a 12 to the rail. He's got some interesting selections here. If he plays, he's got to play this ball first. Went past his mark on the 10. I don't know if he can, yeah, he can make this 10, I think. If he can make the 10, he better shoot it. Because I don't think he's got shape from this, from the 12 to the 10. Might end up overcutting it. Nah, he drilled it clean. He's straight in the side, and it's going to make it 4-2. It were at the Pottawatomie, at the Pottawatomie Hotel and Casino here in Milwaukee, Wisconsin, official host of the BCA Pool League's Wisconsin State Championships. What a super venue. Sergio Rivas played about flawless pool, made a couple, one or two little tiny hiccups. Claudio is, this is a critical game in this match. Claw literally is way back. Oh. No cushion. Foul is, see, on that shot, folks, there was no contact with any object ball at that time, and when they did collide, finally, nothing reached a cushion after contact, even though it was an open table. Mr. Parrone here has his druthers as to what he wants to do. Either one of these selections is not necessarily going to be easy. That's a big, very, very big, big study here. Oh, is that a dangerous shot? Because that eight could have gone down into the side pocket. Beautiful kiss shot. He's got to follow to go into this one and stay on the four no matter what. That isn't what he wanted to do. He got too much English. But he's got the five down here, but I think he wanted to be playing the five last before the eight. He didn't want this. I know he didn't want this. No, he ain't gonna like that. That's a shot that he'll rue the day that he didn't get on at four ball. He's in big trouble. Yeah, bank it down there. He can bank good, but nah, chunked it. Might have left his man nasty, in all fairness. Got one tough cut on the 11 or 13 ball, and that's about it. No other shot. He hitched up his pants. He's going to have to reach for a shot here. Nice. See, he still has to get on the short side of those balls. He gets to play the 15 off the 8. He might be out from here. 14, 15 off the 8, then the 9. No, you don't have that. You got to play 15 off the 8. If you're going to play it. Good shot. Uh-oh. Ain't gonna like that, folks. Safety is the play. Claudio might have a little purple staring out at him on the four ball. Hard to say. didn't kill himself with that. It looks like the boy's going to have to end up making either. He's going to have to cut the, I don't know if he can cut to 14. If he does, he loses his cue ball. Maybe, it's hard to say. He loses his cue ball. What else is it going to do? What's the laws of the universe going to change? Claudio outmoved him. I like Claudio coming off of the inside of this ball and coming up and trying to lock him on the left rail behind the eight. Looks like that. Didn't hit a little too hard. That was the right shot. Tried to lay him on that on the side rail. Real good move. He's going to free this 15 ball. Let's see what he does. This is... He might put him on the inside of the rail on the one ball. You just can't overcome that. Claudio concedes in that game. 5-2. What a shot. Seeing some gangbuster shots. This kid's a player. Years old, they say. I don't think he's ever even going to have to get a work permit with that game. He could play. Claudio pocketed two stripes, has a nice opportunity here on the 12 ball on the side. Or he might play the 11. Playing the 13 and draw it over to the 10 in the same pocket, I'm sure. Well hit. He's going to come two cushions out to the middle of the table for the 15. It's got to hurry. ball is probably good in the side. It is. He's going to end up having to play the 11 in the corner pocket, I think. His angle's a little steep. He's perfect. He'll just bounce off the side rail and be dead straight in on the 8. Nice shot. Very, very nice out for Claudio. Dead straight in, 5-3. Getting a real, real nice match here for the nightcap, folks. These are two outstanding regional players. Come out in Vegas, you operators, get sanctioned for that BCA leagues and get a part of this spectacle out there in the desert, July 22 to August the 1st at the Rio. Step on out there and just go nuts. Have fun. That's the only time he came up dry on the break. Claudia might like the stripes. I kind of like him shooting his 14 and then play the 12. Because, no, he's got to play it this way because he's got to fall in between those balls. Fall in between those balls. He might have to look at the 12 first. Even though the 13 is also probably a better shot because he can draw it up a little bit closer. He hits the rail, he can make a, he's perfect. He's just dead natural on this. Dead natural. Oh. Dead natural. Claudio is turning this into a contest. 5-4, some good shooting. And two real good players. This is this is a great match for the nightcap. Lots of sweaters around here sweating this action after a long day here on the felt. Or at least a medium evening for most of these lifers I'm looking at. But these are the greatest, these people, because they love the game and they're out here just having fun. Five to four, and Claudio has climbed back to being on even serve. Ball is in, and Claudio might be getting on a roll here. He's looking to see if the 12 passed the 2. I sort of like him shooting a 6. Trouble is he doesn't like his angle. He's going to run into the 2. Probably play the 4 and try to get straight in on the 6 where he can squat his ball. He's going to try to draw it across the 12. If he's playing with a shot, I think he's going to play to free him up for the 5. Oh, that was artful. That was a little bit less than what he might have liked, I think. He wanted to make sure that he didn't get on the wrong side of that 7. He's got a little funny on this ball. He's going to have a bigger angle on the 1 than he might have liked, but he sure should be okay. Oh yeah, this is some real entertainment, folks. These two guys are having at it. 5-5. This is a great match. Great match. Doesn't get any better than this. Two very, very good players. One of them is going to have to go to the west side of the bracket. They're not going to find George Maharis over there or Russ Tamblyn or anybody else other than an opponent who may not like it. This is us. Come out and join the BCA Nationals. Sanction your league. Get your players involved. July 22nd, August 1st out at the Rio. 10 days in the desert. It's wild. I've been there several times in my career, and I can tell you that Nothing like it. These guys are all BCA members, and they can all go out to play in those events. That's what sanctioning and the BCA will do for any room or league operator. That could be Heartbreak Hotel there. That could be, he might have breathed his last. This is a rugged layout with pros and cons for each. Claudio, due to the BCA pool league's rule, if it's a scratch on the break, has ball in hand anywhere on the table, and he's going to avail himself of he might play this five ball. I'd like to play the five ball if I'm him. Or if he goes with the stripes, well. This is tough either way. There isn't any real easy solution to this puzzle. Well, must be good on the side. Fifteen ball. Well, he can't believe it. He's going to be, if this 12 does go in the side, this is like looking like all tap-ins to me. Well, I guess he's going to play 11, 12, 9. That's okay, too. Might even go on a kiss shot. As Claudio Parrone took it down, he came from the dead. What a great match. Well, he's a longtime player in this region. That kid, 16 years old, Sergio Rivas, played great too. Made a couple mistakes, and that was it. We're done for the night. Bones and notches, senior. Claudio, I remember you from way back. I was around here from Maryland years ago.
Just say like a few years ago. It makes me feel a little younger.
Oh, thank you.
That's a nice comeback. Thanks.